Well, hello and welcome to Bloomberg Quint. We are in conversation with the management of Aarti Industries, Mr. Rajendra Gogri, joining us. So thank you so much, first of all, for taking the time out and speaking to us. Let me first start off with asking you about the changes that have happened in China. We've been reading multiple reports that suggest that the Indian chemical companies, they are in a sweet spot following the clampdown by the Chinese authorities on the polluting industries. How are you reading into this, and what is the kind of market size that is available for diversified players like you, as well as the others, and how well are you placed in terms of capacity to meet this increased demand?
Yeah, last more than a year, you know, Chinese authorities have clamped down on regarding the pollution issues. So that has created shortages and increased the prices of various products, and a lot of margin increase and higher capacity utilization is happening for Indian chemical industries. But for jump to the next level in volumes, companies will have to invest in the additional facilities. And we are seeing that trend, you know, across the value chain. A lot of our downstream consumption have started increasing and is expected to increase further. So there will be a very long-term benefit on the volumes, as well as long-term there will be an increase in margins than what we used to be in FY18. So company like us also are getting benefit of that, you know, more and more consumption for our products within India, and overall more volume visibilities for us in next few years.
So what is the size of the exports business to China? I assume the share of overall exports stands at about 45% according to your latest FY18 numbers. But what is the share of China in your overall exports?
Overall export, you know, we are about 10% to China. And there we are seeing some shifting coming to India because of the higher shifting of manufacturing, as well as some products which were not exported to China also has been exported right now. You know, there is basically some churning going on in Chinese market.
Where do you see this number coming up to, say, by the end of this year, or probably 2 to 3 years down the line? What would be the share of China to your overall exports?
No, that will, as you see, you know, we are putting up a lot of plants, you know, which are more exported towards US and Europe. So the Chinese exports are, you know, we don't see much significant growth as far as export to China of our product line. So our major growth will be more towards, you know, India as well as in Western countries.
Right.
Volumes.
Right. So coming back to India, and actually my next question is that, because the domestic market is a huge one for you, more than 50% of your revenues come from there, and for most other players as well. So how are you looking at this, and how are you looking at the demand traction in the domestic market? Will the next leg of growth be coming in from here?
The Gujarat government has really announced a few steps in ease of doing business by Honorable Chief Minister Sri Vijay Rupani on giving flexibility on manufacturing of dye stuff, you know. So within the category, you can have flexibility to manufacture different kind of dyes, you know. With this kind of initiative, you will be able to see more and more downstream production in India, and that will help the entire, you know, intermediates and basic chemical in India. And in general, you know, because of this Chinese disruption, both import substitute and export from India is bound to increase. And we are seeing that signs already. And with, you know, if government also becomes more proactive, like what Gujarat government has announced, environment clearance related procedures will is being simplified, and also will be expedited. So combination of all this, you know, it is a very good positive sign for Indian chemical industry.
If I may add, another key positive for your business and for the most other chemical players is the rupee depreciation because of your exposure to exports. How does this impact your margins, sir? You've been doing in the high teens, somewhere around 17.5% to 18.5%. Do we see a scope to reach the 20% mark?
Yeah, definitely. No, if you say FY18, the exchange rate was more towards, you know, 64-65. Now it has been coming to around 70 rupees. So that will definitely help in our margins, both for export as well as, you know, where we compete with China in as an import substitute. And 1.5% or so increase is definitely possible.
So, sir, can you help me with the number? How would it translate in terms of a percentage increase in your margins for every 10 rupee depreciation of the rupee against the dollar?
Now, part of our raw materials are dollar denominated, and generally we count, you know, around 20% of our product is more sensitive towards the exchange rate. So if you count, you know, based on that, a 5% additional depreciation will give an impact about 1% benefit to us.
So that is the 5% depreciation in rupee results in a 1% EBITDA margin increment.
Yeah, more or less you can say of that kind of number.
Okay. Sir, a word
overall
on...
Overall, because we have a huge product mix, so it will not be exact, but as a...
Yeah, go on.
Yeah, so you know, it cannot be very pinpointed to a specific number, but broadly, you know, this kind of benefit should accrue.
Okay. Sir, I was reading an article online, and correct me if I'm wrong, China's Sinopec has cut the domestic benzene prices by about 100 yuan per metric ton. I believe benzene is a key raw material. Can you confirm this, and how are you looking at the raw material price trend at this moment?
Yeah, benzene prices have come down in last 1.5 months. But as you know, our is a raw material pass-through model. So benzene price increase or decrease, you know, doesn't affect our per kg margins as well as our volume. So it definitely will help us in reduction in working capital. But it doesn't impact much on our operating profit.
Right. Sir, a question on the customer concentration. I was going through one of the reports from a brokerage house which says that more than 80% of your revenues, they come from customers that have been with you for over 5 years. How do you look at, diversifying your customer base now that you've also entered into multiple long-term contracts? So have you been in the process of adding more customers?
Actually, we already have a huge customer base, you know, already about 1,000 customers if you take local and global. And our largest customer doesn't contribute more than 7-8% of sales. The point what was mentioned is that we have very continuity of customer relations on a long-term basis. We have a lot of sustained strategic relationship with most of our customers, and it gives very longevity of business. But it's not a customer concentration. We have a very wide range of customer across the globe in various end-use industries. So that way, you know, we are very well-balanced already.
Sir, in a word on those long-term contracts, are you in talks with any of the other multinational companies for such orders?
Yeah, you know, in general, the Indian manufacturing is becoming attractive, and we are in continuously, you know, looking at those opportunities, and we'll definitely, you know, we are confident that those kind of opportunities would further materialize in coming years.
So then do we have the necessary capacity in place, and what are your future capex plans?
Yeah, we are increasing our guidance for capex for next year, and also we have announced that, you know, we are planning to raise some funds about 750 crores. So that will give us an additional capital to capitalize on all these various potential opportunities in next 2-3 years.
So last question from my side. I remember speaking to you the last time, and you had mentioned about the demerger of your home and personal care business by the end of this year. Any update with respect to that?
Yeah, I think that is on track, and we should be able to do by end of this financial year.
Okay, sir. We'll leave it at that. Thank you so much for taking the time out and speaking to us.